This is a presentation on debits and credits used in accounting. Debits and credits are everywhere in accounting, which brings us to a catch-22 when trying to explain what they are. Because I can't help but talk about T-accounts and journal entries when I explain debits and credits, and yet to understand T-accounts and journal entries, you have to know a little bit about, well, debits and credits. So if I mention something such as a T-account and you're not sure what it is, just check your accounting textbook or click on any of the links that I've provided to some of my other videos. So let's get started. What are debits and credits? A very common definition is that debits are on the left and credits are on the right. And it's a pretty good definition, but it doesn't tell us how they're used. So let's expand on this. Debits are on the left-hand side of a T-account. Here's a cash T-account. The $100 is on the left-hand side. The $100 is a debit. Credits are on the right-hand side of a T-account. Here's another cash T-account. The $75 is on the right-hand side. The $75 is a credit to cash. If you're not sure what a T-account is, just click below to watch my video on T-accounts and account balances. Let's take another cash T-account. Let's say a business takes in $100 of cash from a sale. We would debit cash because cash increased. And let's say the business paid $75 for an expense using cash. $75 is credited to cash, and we put it on the right. And finally, we'd like to know our balance, and in this case, it's a $25 debit balance, and the $25 goes on the left. Now, many students get confused as to whether the $100 should go on the left or on the right. In other words, they're confused as to whether we should debit or credit cash when cash increases. And more generally, when do we debit an account and when do we credit it? And that all depends on the account that we're working on. In this case, we used cash, but other accounts are sales, rent, and interest. And it all depends on if we want to increase the balance of the account or decrease it. Debits increase asset, withdrawal, and expense accounts, while credits increase liability, capital, and revenue accounts. An example of an asset account is cash. And an example of a revenue account is sales. This all has to do with normal balances. If you'd like, click on the link below to watch my video on normal balances. Let's take an example of a cash sale. And remember that in double entry accounting, every transaction affects at least two accounts. Let's say a customer comes into a business and the business sells $100 worth of merchandise and receives $100. In this cash sale of $100, cash increased by $100 and sales increased by $100. We would debit cash for $100 and credit sales for $100. Here's our cash T account. Since cash increased, we would debit the cash account by $100 and put that on the left. Here's our sales T account. Since sales increased, we would credit the account by putting the $100 on the right. If we were to write a journal entry on this, we would put the debit of cash of $100 on the left-hand side, whereas the credit to sales for $100 would be indented to the right. And that's our journal entry. If you'd like to see more on journal entries, just click on the link below. And there you go, debits and credits. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching.